Well, that's it for harvest 2022. Been some long days, you know, doing the 9 to 5 out here farming. I mean, it's an honest day.
Hello and welcome to the Mike Less Farmhand Mike YouTube channel, bringing you some of the biggest and best variety and definitely the most versatile farming content on social media today. You can find me on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook at Farmhand Mike. Hey everyone, I am back for Harvest Part 2 here in Dark County, Ohio. I took some vacation time in October to help out here finish up the harvest, and we had a beautiful fall, let me tell you. I already put a video up earlier in the season as we got started into the corn and the soybeans, but you know, I randomly take some clips each day as I'm helping out here with the GoPro inside the cab, depending what I'm running, pop the drone up every now and then. And I'm going to share that all with you here as we finish up the soybean harvest, move on to corn, a little bit of tillage in this video. We take a ride to the ethanol plant in Greenville, Ohio, and all that good stuff. It's going to be a little bit of a long video as this video ranges from Arcanum, Ohio, all the way to Winchester, Indiana. Starting out here, I'm running the John Deere 8260R tractor in a J&M grain cart while I'm flying the drone. And the owner of the combine, Jeff, is running his S780 combine with the 45-foot flex draper head. And right beside us was Dick Levy Farms as they were out here cutting soybeans. I mean, this field connected, so I had a little extra time while I'm running grain cart. With soybeans, it's not as hectic as it is with corn, so I flew over here, got some pictures of their Case International 8250 combines with their 45-foot MacDon flex draper heads. Seems like I end up popping the drone up in this field quite a bit with those grain silos in the background you see there. I actually filmed Dick Levy Farms planting this field back in the spring. I did post that video already. But anyways, I was not able to get any tractor and grain cart action in here, but you can see all three combines there, some in the background, whatnot. But I had to get back to work, so couldn't get it all. But here's a little sneak peek of that. This was down to our last two fields of soybeans here. Once we got this field done, we had to move down the railroad tracks a little bit, just enough we had to take the header off to make the move. But anyways, once we got to that field, I switched off, ran the combine for a bit, and it was very dusty, as you're gonna see coming up here. But before we jump to the next field, let's watch this machinery in this field while I got the drone up in the air on this beautiful October day. are now moving to the very last field of soybeans for the 2022 season. This field was pretty much right beside the one you saw in the drone shots right there, but there's a little bit of a break. This is an old railroad track we're going down, and a 45-foot head would just not quite fit from the one field to the other, so we had to take it off. And here we go, we're gonna hook it up, and we're gonna roll that beautiful bean footage into the night. I'm officially on combine duty now. Not that that's a bad thing. It is dusty. Officially done with soybeans. I'm going to drive the 8260R back. I'm going to unhook the grain cart, and I got a brand new tractor to hook up. So we're going to give something else a whirl here. A black Deutz Fahr 8280 tractor with the Warrior package. So black tractor, black grain cart, a pretty good looking setup.
tell you, with this CVT transmission, the air ride cab, suspended front axle, everything else, just a nice tractor to have on the grain cart. I'm really liking it here. Guys, got a little downtime this morning. We're heading up to the ethanol plant. I have never been to the ethanol plant, so I'm gonna ride up there with Super Trucker Hank, and we're gonna dump a couple loads of corn up here at the ethanol plant, and then we should be ready to go back in the field. Our grain dryer should be caught up then, so come along for the ride to the ethanol plant in Greenville. 127 northbound, anyone got a copy? Come on.
All right, I'm going to try to work some ground this morning. We'll see what happens here. It hasn't rained here since probably mid-August, so the ground is super hard. A couple guys have started on the tillage, and some guys are getting in the ground, some aren't. But we're going to give it a whirl and see what happens, so stay tuned. It did frost here last night. It's 37 degrees right now. Sun's up. Looks like we're in for a beautiful day. So I'm going to do this for a couple hours if it works, and then we're going to go back to shelling corn.
Probably better check the oil first.
Oil's good. I gave it an 85-point DOT inspection, so I'm going to start the tractor up, let it warm up a bit, and I'm going to go try the field out here behind the barn.
As dry as it's been and as hard as the ground was, this thing was doing a really good job. I mean, this high-speed disc has always done a good job, but in these conditions, I am really impressed what it's doing. Running about 3.5 inches deep and about 12 mile an hour. And flying the drone.
running combine and have that view over there, it's almost like watching that Farmhand Mike guy on YouTube. Like watching that Farmhand Mike guy on YouTube. That is one good looking tractor and grain cart, I must say so myself. Thank you. That's it. That's gonna do her. Harvest 2022. Well, that's it for Harvest 2022. Been some long days, you know, doing the 9 to 5 out here farming. I mean, it's an honest day's work, but I'll be glad to go back to the, you know, 10 to 2 now. So 9 to 5 for several weeks, you know, is really pushing my limits there. But anyways, good to be done, but we got a lot of machinery to clean up, tillage, all that good stuff. And of course, I'm gonna have other people to film, but harvest in the area is wrapping up pretty good. A lot of guys are getting done now. A lot of guys been done, but this was it. And finished over here in the state of Indiana, and gonna head for the house. Might get done early today.
Going to do it for this video. If you did like this video, please go down there and hit that like button, and feel free to comment below. If you're new to my YouTube channel, I would really appreciate it if you go down there and hit subscribe and check back often. Just because we're done here at home doesn't mean I'm done doing harvest videos. I still have a lot of footage from other farms. I have wheat harvest videos from last summer throughout the country, corn silage, other corn and soybean harvest videos coming to my YouTube channel yet. As soon as I get time to edit them, I'll get those up here through the winter. And if you want to see more of what I'm doing, what I'm out in the field with filming, you can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok at Farmhand Mike. As always, thank you for watching and supporting my social media.